These are the finest tools you'll ever lay eyes on.
The fine.
Good to see you're getting along. So, Broker, do you accept your duty?
Don't have much choice, do I? Last thing I need is a godly smiting up me arse.
Let this be the start of a beautiful new friendship.
To study the Salakar, I'll need the very best of tools. Too bad this workshop is lacking.
Bugger off! I got more stuff here than you can wag a finger at.
Doubt it.
If you find something you don't know how to use, just ask.
I'll be giving you lessons on how to use your
own... Bickering dwarves. How unusual.
Asa, you return.
What? You deal with a fire nymph?
Not this again.
What news do you bring?
My stepmother is stubborn. I cannot push too hard or she will grow suspicious.
She has no interest in a trade.
Interest, yes. But not yet the will.
I don't understand.
The Salakar is all but indestructible. You, on the other hand, are not.
She assumes she'll catch me, kill me, and retrieve the Salakar.
Time is on her side.
Then I must strip her of this illusion. If I were to make a nuisance of myself, one that cannot be ignored.
Sinmarra prepares to lead my father's next major invasion.
But if I were to disrupt her plans, it may force her to the bargaining table.
Sounds risky to me.
I once plotted and carried out the murder of Ymir himself. What do I care of risk?
Well, since you put it like that...
Where must I strike?
At Af Alvat Milna. My stepmother develops a strange army. At Jofursmida, she breeds beasts of war. And finally, there's Drekathorpe, her supplies hub.
I'll deal with all three.
In the meantime, I shall return to Eitri. I will send word once my stepmother has become more... amenable.
I'll return when I'm done, and I will expect answers regarding the Salakar.
This is where the she-demon stores her precious supplies. This area is off limits.
They say the battle is predetermined, right? So why bother with all the enemies? Going to kill or fight?
These warriors with grumbling bellies and only sticks with which to fight.
Getting away from me!
must be careful now.
Unleash the beasts.
Oh,
Without these plans, no further beasts can be bred. No more piggies for you, Sinmarra. Once Baldr's free, he and I shall feast on the roasted flesh of these mighty pigs.
Come on!
Understanding of the Salakar's true use. My future may depend on it. Ragnarok is inevitable. To avoid it, impossible. But if there's one thing I know, impossible is impossible. Sinmarra's plans lie in ruins.
I just hope you know what you're doing.
Surely I should be asking that of you. Now, tell me, what does it do?
I ain't got a clue. These light elves and they're sneaky.
You've learned nothing?
Whatever its use, the power it contains. It holds more than what you said.
Such as?
Well, for a start, there's a bloody dwarf in there.
Anyone we know?
Nah, and it's not important. Dwarf hugers don't carry much weight. Not even mine.
So, what does it contain?
All I know is that it's more than Malvigir, Kaldr, and some dwarf no one cares about.
Fine. In the stories, what was the actual point of the Salakars?
Hugers were what vitalized them. But it was the magic that gave them their purpose. And that magic was different to each one.
Magic? You mean Seda?
Nah, some elf shit no one knows anymore.
Except Suter.
That fire nymph? She sent word.
And?
Your plan worked. Sinmarra's ready to barter, if it means getting you out of the way.
Where?
At the bridge leading to Fagarda. Light the beacon, and she'll come out with your lad.
The power that the Salakar holds, it must not fall into Surtur's grasp.
Nah, I'll reclaim it once Baldr is safe. My arrival.
You bring that which is Sutter's.
Give me what is mine. And I will hand over what is his.
Come midway.
Baldr, I got you. I got you.
Baldr's behind one of these doors. Locked cells. I must find the proper keys. Truly, Calder. Truly. Dare to torture my own flesh and blood. If only I could bring you back from the dead and kill you all over again. This blood trail. Whoever was dragged here was badly wounded. Yet he was strong. It took at least 4 jailers to hold him. Written in Baldr's hand. No light, but only darkness visible. Revealing sights of woe. Realms of endless agony. This hopelessness, it is not the Baldr I know. No matter his pain and turmoil, there, beyond that door lies the dark house of prison. And my son. Key bearing a skull. That is what I need to access the chin.
High one, brought low. Mistletoe, symbol of hope, renewal, but not for Baldr. We forced so many drafts down his gullet. His torment was quite beautiful. Blind fool, you never saw what was in front of you. Here is your child. His light gone before you even set foot here. And the rest of him? It now skulks in Helheim. Allow me to reunite you with your boy.
No!
Traitor. You were never worth my effort. I've seen dwarves with better stature. Take care of it. Asgard, but you are an imposter. Heart as black as tar. Savage. Monstrous. You've locked that truth away. Built a code to act as its jailer. But the darkness cannot be kept hidden. It oozes out like pus from a wound. Poisoning everything it touches. That is what it means to be Odin the Deceiver. Come to the flame! You cluck and scratch like an old hen! What is it? What did you see?
All my struggles mattered nothing in the end. My son was lost before he began. His premonition come to pass.
Your son?
Baldr. Havi's son. You know what I mean.
So Baldr met his fate, as was foretold. Ever you have sought to elude the looms of the Nornir. But we are all caught in their weave.
No, I will not believe it. There is more to see yet. Why was I thrown from my dream?
Perhaps it was not the vision that rejected you, but you who rejected the vision. Perhaps you are afraid of it.
I fear nothing.
I think you do. And until you recognize that fear, give in to it, embrace it, the vision will not return. Some walls cannot be overcome by potions alone.
Tell me what I must do. This saga does not end here. It cannot.
Meet me in the forest when darkness lays upon the land. There we shall see how fearless you truly are.